What you have to do? You have to type www.menti.com and type the code. They will be asking a code 7224-2282. Open menti.com in a separate tab and type the code 7224-2282 and answer the question in front of you. 7224-2282. This is the code. Come on, hurry up. Answer the question in front of you. What kind of energy is in flower pot sitting on a windowsill? This is the question. So you have to select the correct option. Yes, one student responded. I repeat the code. 7224-2282. Menti.com you have to open. Yes, four students have responded. Yes, very good. Six students have done that. Yes, come on. 10 students responded. Others also, all of you, do this. This will just take a while. Eleven students are able to do. It's totally confidential. I won't come to know whose answer is wrong. So open-heartedly, you can answer the question. No need to hesitate. 13 students have done. 14, 15. What about others? Yes, hurry up. I'll wait for 2 more minutes. 17 students have done this. I repeat the code 7224-2282. Open menti.com. Fill in this code. Is this screen visible? My screen is visible to you? Okay. 19 students are able to do. Okay. So I'm closing it. 15 students out of total are saying potential energy. 2 students are saying kinetic and 2 students are saying both. So which one is correct? Yes, 20 students have responded. Good. Out of 34, 20 are able to do. So the correct answer obviously is potential energy. How it is kinetic or both? It must be only potential energy, right? Because the flower pot is kept on a window. It is kept at a height from the ground. So that means it has potential energy and specifically gravitational potential energy. All right. Okay. So who will tell me now what is elastic potential energy I'm talking about? Yesterday we did this. So tell me what is elastic potential energy? Raise hand. Yes, Aryan.
The an object due to change in its shape is called elastic potential energy.
Very good. So energy possessed by an object due to change in shape, that is called elastic potential energy. Very good. Can you give any example? Yes, Jatin.
Example, stretched bow and compressed spring.
Yes, stretched rubber band, stretched bow, compressed spring, all these. Very good. Okay, so we had done the derivation of kinetic energy. Who will tell me the formula of kinetic energy? Yes, Karanveer.
KE equals to half mv square.
Yes, kinetic energy is half mv square. Very good. Okay, now let us find relation between kinetic energy and momentum. We know both the expressions. So relation between kinetic energy and momentum, you know, P. Who will tell me the formula of momentum, if you remember? In second chapter, we did a lot about momentum. Yes, Titiksha. What?
P is equal to mv.
Yes, your voice is not clear. P is equal to mv. So we know the expressions. Kinetic energy, let us indicate by E only. Half mv square. And momentum is mv. We know both the expressions. Let's find a relationship between the two. If we concentrate on kinetic energy and multiply and divide right hand side by mass m. Multiply and divide the right hand side by mass m. So see, in the denominator you have 2 into m, 2m. And in the numerator, mv square multiplied by m becomes m square v square. I hope this step is clear to you. If not, you can raise the hand. So it becomes m square v square over 2m. We can write m square v square as mv square. No problem, we can write. Okay, and you can see what is mv equal to. Mv is equal to p. So we can substitute in place of mv p. And since it is squared, we have to put P square. So this is the relationship between kinetic energy and momentum, that E is equal to P square upon 2m. Direct relationship we can write. Okay, so learn this formula. Can you express now momentum in terms of kinetic energy using the same formula, just modify it? How can you write P in terms of kinetic energy E? Yes, who will tell? Just cross multiply it. Okay, cross multiply it. 2m goes on that side. 2me is equal to P square. Or P square is equal to 2me. So P can be written as under root 2me. So this is another formula. Directly, if you want to express momentum in terms of kinetic energy, you can just simply say P is equal to under root 2m. Okay, so then we can have numericals on the basis of this relation also. Write one question. Write down a question. Two objects one lighter of mass small m and another heavier of mass capital M two objects one lighter of mass small m another heavier of mass capital M have same kinetic energy. which of them has smaller momentum? Which of them has smaller momentum? Okay, so let's solve this. Same kinetic energy. First of all, let's write kinetic energy of heavier mass. Capital E, let us write it. And let us use capital symbols for it. Capital E is half capital M capital V square. And for a lighter object, let's write small e, half small m, small v square. According to the question, they have same kinetic energy. So capital E is equal to small e. Put the values. Half m v square is half small m, small v square. Okay. Half gets cancelled. This is one method, first of all. Elaborated method, I'm telling you, first of all. Okay, the lengthier one. So in this case, you can write V square over small V square. Capital V square over small V square. It can be written as small m over capital M. Let us call it equation number one. Or let's not call it equation number one. Let's write one step further. We can write capital V over small v is under root small m over capital M. Let us call this equation number one. So velocities we have found in terms of masses. Now we want to find which one is having smaller momentum. Okay. So let us write the momentum of bigger object. Capital MV and smaller object small p is small m small v. Let's find their ratio. Capital MV over small mv. We can write m by m. We know that capital M is greater than small m, but we didn't have any idea about their speeds. Okay, it is given in the question that one object is lighter and another is smaller. So capital M is definitely greater than small m. Okay, but we didn't have an idea about their speed. So that's why we expressed the velocities ratio in terms of masses in equation number one. So let us put the value of capital V over small v from equation number one here. So when we will substitute, it is under root small m over capital M. If any step is not clear, you can ask. Okay. Now, we can write capital M as under root m. Is this step clear? Can you write capital M as under root m? And small m as under root small m. In maths, you must be knowing this. So this capital, this under root capital M gets cancelled, under root small m gets cancelled. And we are left with under root capital M by small m now. Now at least one quantity we are getting. Okay. Now, because capital M is greater than small m, capital P must be greater than small p. That means momentum of heavier object is more. So according to the question, what should be our answer? Lighter object. So which one is having smaller momentum? Lighter object is having smaller momentum. So have a look at the whole question. This is quite lengthy method. Now we'll do the same question by shortcut. First, see all the steps. If any step is not clear, you can ask. Okay. Yes.
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम, मैम जहाँ से आपने किया था ना ये बिग एम ओवर स्मॉल एम, फिर उसके बाद मैम अंडर रूट स्मॉल एम ओवर बिग एम, मैम वहां से नहीं समझ आया.
ओके, वहां पे आफ्टर दैट जस्ट आई हैव रिटन कैपिटल एम एज अंडर रूट कैपिटल एम. सी व्हेन आई राइट एम एज अंडर रूट ऑफ दिस अंडर रूट ऑफ दिस, दिस में कम्स under root of m into m, that is under root of m square. This square and under root get cancelled and we get only m. That means we can write m as under root m also. One and the same thing. Same way in the denominator, I have substituted small m as under root small m. In maths, you must be doing this. Okay, so let us do the same question by using that direct formula we just derived. So now the lighter and heavier object, they have same kinetic energy, we just want to find the momentum. So let us use the direct formula of momentum for heavier object, for lighter object. Okay. Small letters I have used for lighter object and capital letters I have used for heavier object. Now let's find again the ratio. That is under root 2 capital M E under root 2 small m small e. Now see what gets cancelled in the numerator and denominator. 2 gets cancelled, under root 2 means. And according to the question, energies, kinetic energies are same, so also get cancelled. Directly we get the ratio under root capital M over small m. This relation we got from the previous method after so much of effort. But here directly we are getting that relationship. So again you will say because capital M is greater than small m, therefore capital P must be greater than small m. So again, we will get to know that heavier object will have more momentum, and according to the question, our answer is lighter object because they are asking which of them is having lesser momentum. So this is the question. Okay, fine. Is that clear, students? Yes, Aryan. You want to ask anything? You just raised hand. Yes.
एनर्जी को के भी लिख सकते हैं क्या मैम? काइनेटिक एनर्जी को
हाँ के भी लिख सकते हो, बट सिंस वी आर यूजिंग अ सिंबल फॉर इट सो दैट्स व्हाई आई हैव यूज्ड ई ओनली. अदरवाइज आप काइनेटिक एनर्जी भी लिख सकते हो, ठीक है? आप ई वन ई टू भी लिख सकते हो, काइनेटिक एनर्जी के ई वन के ई टू भी लिख सकते हो, दैट इज योर चॉइस. सिंबल्स की कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं, ठीक है? So I hope this question is clear to you. Write one more numerical on this basis. Write down one more question. Write down. If momentum of an object, increases by if momentum of an object increases by 20%, calculate the percentage increase in kinetic energy. Calculate the percentage increase in its kinetic energy. So let's do this type of question. According to the question, momentum increases by, new momentum is P dash suppose. It increases by how much? 20%. So P plus 20% of P. New momentum according to the question is previous momentum plus 20% और बढ़ गया उसको. तो ऐसे ही लिखते हो ना मैथ्स में आप. Is this statement clear first of all? New momentum is original momentum plus 20% of that. It increases by 20%. 20% और increase हो रहा है. तो हमने जो momentum थी उसमें 20% और add कर दी. So see what do we get? 20% means 20 over 100 into P. Okay, that is 1 by 5. P dash is P plus P by 5, that means. Take the LCM, this becomes 6P by 5. So new momentum we have found 6P by 5. Let's call it equation number 1. यहां तक देखो पहले step clear है आपको. Is this step clear? Okay. Now we have to find, since momentum is increasing, obviously kinetic energy will also increase. They are directly proportional, right? So we have to find now change in percentage change in kinetic energy. I tell you the formula. Percentage in kinetic energy. The formula will be E dash minus E, मतलब पहले change लेते हैं, over original E into 100. This is the formula. Same way, if percentage change in momentum is asked, you can apply the same formula, P dash minus P over P into 100. For any quantity, you can apply this formula to find the percentage. For example, you find the percentage of your marks also like that. Right? So, but this is percentage change. Right? Let us now original E, we know, is P square by 2m. How it is related to momentum, we know this formula directly. What will be new E, E dash? It will be P dash square over 2m. Because momentum is changing, kinetic energy will also change. Right? Let's put the value of P dash from equation number 1. 6P by 5 square over 2m. Okay. Solve this, how you can write it? You can write 36 by 25, P square by 2m, keep it separate. Don't mix 2 here, don't cancel out 36 with 2. Because this P square by 2m is our energy E. So we can still put it equal to E. So we can write it E. We get E dash from here. Ye step dekho pehle yahan tak clear hai aapko. See, if you want to ask, you can ask. E dash is 36 by 25 E. If it is not clear to anyone, you can raise hand. Yes, Karanveer. What's not clear?
Ma'am, how P dash equals to 6P upon 5?
शुरू में देखो मैंने आपको क्या कहा. According to the question, they are saying momentum is increasing by 20%. तो जब हमने momentum में 20% of momentum add कर दिया, उसको solve किया ना, 20% को 20 by 100 लिख लेते हैं. 20 by 100 means 1 by 5. तो when you take LCM, it becomes 6P by 5. Okay, is the step clear now? Okay, so let us find percentage increase in kinetic energy. Yes, Jatin.
Ma'am, ek bar 6P by 5 ke step ke baad bata do ek bar dobara.
Ha, uske baad abhi humne formula derive kiya na, E is equal to P square by 2m. है ना? तो वो सेम वे अब मोमेंटम क्योंकि चेंज हो रही है, पी से पी डैश हो रही है, तो ई ई से ई डैश हो जाएगा. मास तो उन्होंने चेंज ही नहीं किया, तो उसको हमने 2m ही लिख दिया. नाउ वी हैव सब्स्टिट्यूटेड द वैल्यू ऑफ पी डैश व्हिच इज 6p / 5. क्योंकि फार्मूला में स्क्वायर है, तो हमने भी 6p / 5 का स्क्वायर कर दिया. इट बिकम 36 / 25. और जो साइड पे p स्क्वायर / 2m है, दैट इज e, उसको e पुट कर दिया. सो e डैश इज 36 / 25 e. Got it? Is it clear, Jatin?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Okay.
So let us put now value here. E dash minus E over E into 100. E dash is 36 by 25 E minus E over E into 100. Can you solve now? Solve this. Take the LCM. So check your answer. Is it 44%? Yes, students, check your answer. Is it 44%? Right? So this is how you can do these kinds of numerical problems. If in numerical, kinetic energy increase is given in percentage, you can find the increase in percentage, increase in momentum also in the same way. Then you will use the formula P is under root 2m. Okay, then you will use this formula. Yes, Arush.
No, I was just about to lower my hand. Actually, your voice started cracking.
Yes, you just what?
Ma'am, I was just about to lower my hand. Actually, your voice started cracking in between.
So, is this numerical clear to everyone? If not, you can still ask. Clear? Okay. So, let us come to the previous derivation. Okay, that we did yesterday of kinetic energy. Let's do. Recall that derivation. This was the derivation. Is this clear to you? Now, a similar article we are having. Work energy theorem. Give the heading. Work energy theorem. Work energy theorem. Now, what does it state? It states that whenever a force acts on a body, work is done. And work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. We will see that. Jab bhi work hoga, kinetic energy bhi change hogi object. This is called work energy theorem. So, write down the statement, then we will derive it. Write down. When a force acts on an object, when a force acts on an object, work is done. Matlab agar displacement hogi, to work is done. Full stop. The work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. Work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. Okay, let's write work W, okay, and change in kinetic energy as final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy, aise hi hoga na, change matlab final minus initial, like we used to do in second chapter, change in momentum, PF minus PI, final minus initial. Same way we do with velocities also, V minus U, final velocity minus initial velocity. So same way here, work done is equal to final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. This is our statement. So that means, what do we want to prove? How can we write final kinetic energy? If we write half m V square, half m final velocity square, it will be final kinetic energy. And if we write half m u square, if we use initial velocity, it will be initial kinetic energy. Is this step clear? Any doubt? So take m by 2 common out of it. V square minus u square. This is your formula for work energy theorem. So directly in some questions, we can use this formula as well. So work done is equal to half m v square minus u square. That is the formula. Okay, that is the formula. Is that clear, students? Work energy theorem statement. Yes.